If you are a dropshipping beginner, you probably already heard about the most popular e-commerce platforms on the market for running an online store, Shopify and WooCommerce. These are the two of the biggest e-commerce platforms in the world. Here is the current e-commerce usage distribution in the top 1 million sites. In other words, this is the distribution for websites using e-commerce technologies. As you can see, 21% of these sites use Shopify while 28% use WooCommerce to power their online stores. This means that both of these platforms are great and super popular, having multiple strengths, and can be the perfect solution for you to build an e-commerce store with. More than that, choosing either Shopify and WooCommerce gives you the chance to do it all on your own without any help from professional designers or developers. But which one should you choose for your dropshipping store? Which one is better for your dropshipping needs? And which has more features that work for you, and which is cheaper? This video will answer all these questions and more. And by the end of it, hopefully you can make up your mind about which platform to choose. Stay tuned and see you after the intro. So, let's find out what is Shopify and how to start with this e-commerce platform. Shopify is an all-in-one e-commerce platform that gives you all the tools and features you need to set up your online store from the ground up. So, you have everything you need to manage your store within the platform, from web hosting to security to marketing apps and fulfillment solutions, among others. This actually means that a Shopify store is easy to set up, as you won't need any technical skills or other external help to run your store. To start creating your first Shopify store, here are the first steps to take. 1. Create a Shopify account. 2. Purchase a domain, or if you have already one, you can simply integrate it with Shopify. 3. Pick your Shopify theme, install and then configure it. 4. Set up your shipping and payment settings and other Shopify features. 5. Import or create products. 6. Start selling. Now, let's move to the second part of our topic. What is WooCommerce and how to start? On the other side, we have WooCommerce, the most popular e-commerce solution out there. But why is it so popular? Well, essentially because WooCommerce is a WordPress plugin that was solely built for this platform, and as you can imagine, there are quite a few WordPress websites out there. And most important, both WordPress and WooCommerce are free to use. So, if and when WordPress users want to change their website into an e-commerce store, they simply need to install the WooCommerce plugin. Being an open-source content management system means you can just install it for free, and therefore apply e-commerce functions and features to your existing site. Once you decide to use WooCommerce for your first online store, you need to go through a few steps. Now, the next steps apply to those of you who don't have an existing WordPress website yet. So, if you're starting from scratch, here's what you need to do. 1. Set up a domain and web host. 2. Install WordPress. 3. Install WooCommerce plugin. 4. Pick a theme. Install and then configure it to look according to your needs. 5. Set up the WooCommerce features and settings, such as payment methods, tax rules, shipping zones, and so on. What's the main big difference between Shopify and WooCommerce? As you probably figured it out, these two e-commerce platforms seem similar in a way. But actually, they offer quite different features and tools. We can even say they are built essentially differently for setting up your online store. From the fact that WooCommerce and Shopify integrate differently into your business to the cost of each of them, both platforms have their own specific way to help you set up your e-commerce store. On one hand, Shopify is built to deliver a complete e-commerce solution with all the features you need to create a store from the ground up. You can manage everything from the platform and you don't need any other tool, or at least this is what Shopify says. On the other hand, WooCommerce is an open-source plugin that you can customize and model however you like for your business needs. So, that's probably the biggest difference between these two, and is mentioned in all comparisons that are made between Shopify and WooCommerce that you can find online. Shopify is built with everything in mind for all your e-commerce basic needs being also cloud-hosted, while WooCommerce is mainly built for more tech-savvy users for which you need to take care of the hosting. This is pretty much the most common difference between Shopify and WooCommerce, but as we will let you know below, you will see is not necessarily correct. Shopify can get really complicated once you start installing all kinds of apps to add new functionalities, while WooCommerce can become easier to work with if you set up and use it the right way from the start. In other words, you're probably going to choose Shopify if you want an all-in-one platform for your e-commerce store. One that will get your store running fast and has lots of the most common features and apps built in. or you will probably go for WooCommerce if you want more control over your store and maybe add some custom functionalities. As Shopify has its limits when you want to add complex features or when you need to connect it to some third-party tools or services. So, why choose Shopify? To help you better understand what Shopify brings to the table, here are some pros and cons of the platform. Pros: 1. Fixed pricing plans that you can pay monthly or yearly. 2. Multiple apps to extend your store and a huge apps marketplace. 3. Multiple beautiful themes, both free and paid. 4. Shopify will take care of everything, from hosting to security. 5. You can launch your store in a day. 6. Dropshipping is simple with Shopify. 7. Multiple apps built for dropshipping. 8. Good customer support. 9. If you are eligible for Shopify payments and you decide to use it, this means less headaches for you, as this is their built-in payment method. Now, here are the cons of choosing Shopify. 1. You don't have a lot of control over your site. 2. Not a lot of room for customization. Adding new functionalities can get really complicated. 3. You have a monthly payment that can get higher in time. 4. On top of the monthly and yearly subscription, you also need to pay a fee between 0.5% and 2% based on the subscription plan that can grow your monthly invoice exponentially. 5. Most of the apps are paid, so basically for every new functionality you will need to add more to your monthly invoice. 6. The themes are beautiful, but the best ones are very expensive. 7. Even though Shopify Payments is great to have, only companies incorporated in a few countries are eligible to use it. Now let's move to our second option. Why choose WooCommerce? Here are some pros and cons to help you decide if WooCommerce is the right platform for you. We will start with the pros. 1. You have complete customization and control. 2. Access to a huge online community. 3. Endless themes and plugins. 4. Once you have a WordPress website, it's easy to install and configure WooCommerce. 5. Both WordPress and WooCommerce plugins are free. 6. Cheap developers if you need extra help compared with Shopify, which is 2-3x more expensive. Now, let's see the cons. 1. It takes time to learn the basis of WordPress. 2. WooCommerce may end up being more expensive at the beginning if you really want to build a super complex and custom store due to plugins and themes, but at least you pay for them once and not monthly. 3. You have to manage everything, be it hosting, security, maintenance, or backups. 4. Hosting is one of the main costs to run a WooCommerce store, and it might be difficult at the beginning to configure it properly if you don't have any experience with it. Fortunately, there are solutions for that. Now, what should you keep in mind when choosing an e-commerce platform? Before going into more details about each of these platforms, here are a few important things you need to keep in mind before making any decision. So, how easy is it for you to use the platform? How much do you know about building websites and e-commerce stores? If this is not your first store with platforms like Shopify or WooCommerce, then you could definitely go for either of them depending on how much control you want to have over your store. But if you're just now starting out and it's your first time building an online store from scratch, then Shopify's user-friendliness will probably be great for you. For a newbie, WooCommerce can seem very intimidating, as there are a lot of technicalities you need to be used to already, especially at the beginning when you need to set up everything. Now, let's mention super quick the main features of each platform. We will start with Shopify. 1. Mobile-friendly design. 2. Website builder. 3. Premium themes. 4. Blogging capabilities. 5. Social media integration. 6. SEO-ready site structure. 7. Email marketing integration. 8. Dropshipping capabilities. 9. Free SSL certificate. 10. Built-in credit card payments offered by Shopify directly. Now, here are some of the features you can benefit from if you choose WooCommerce. 1. Many payment gateways available. 2. Mobile-friendly design. 3. Adjustable shipping rates and taxes. 4. Possibility of selling both digital and physical products very easily. 5. Complete control over your data. 6. Tens of thousands of plugins available, both free and paid. 7. Customizable for all possible needs. If you need to build a marketplace, for example, that's very easy to do, and there are plenty of plugins for that, including free ones. 8. Many integrations are available with all kinds of third-party services or platforms. Another very big difference between these two platforms is the price you need to pay. Now, as this subject is a bit more complex, we will try to break it down into initial costs and long-term costs. The initial costs to set up an online store are crucial, of course, and that's even more true if you're a newbie and don't have a big budget. So what's the initial cost for Shopify? A basic plan to get a Shopify e-commerce store up and running is $29 per month and can get up to $299 a month. On top of that, If you don't have one, you may need to purchase a domain for your site, and can do that within Shopify at a starting cost of $14 a year, or you can use a platform like GoDaddy or Namecheap to get your domain, but the prices are pretty similar. So to sum up, the initial cost to set up a very basic Shopify e-commerce store can get to $43 if you decide on the basic Shopify plan. That means the minimum price would be $43 for the first month, and it will go up if you decide to install any new app or paid theme. What's the initial cost for WooCommerce? As we already said, WooCommerce is free but not exactly. What does that mean? It's a free WordPress plugin that you don't have to pay for. But you do need a domain name and hosting for your website, which actually means you have some initial costs to get started with WooCommerce as well. So if you are planning to launch a one-product store or a store around small niche with just 40 or 50 products, then you can work with a basic WooCommerce hosting account that costs only about $10 to $20 per month. You would also need to buy a domain name, which costs around $10 in the first year. This gives us an initial cost of around $20 to $30 to get up and running a basic store with WooCommerce. Of course, you would pay more if you want to add a premium WooCommerce theme or any paid plugins for some extra functionality. So as you can see, the cost to start for both Shopify and WooCommerce is pretty much the same. But what about the long-term costs? Now, things are a bit different when getting to long-term costs. If you go for $29 per month to run your store on Shopify, then annually it will cost you $348, but this basic plan also comes with an additional 2% transaction fee. So, for example, if you sell, let's say, $1,000 per month for your first year, that's $12,000, and the transaction fee would be $240 per year. Let's take another example. If you sell $500 per day, that's around $15,000 per month and around $180,000 per year. In this case, you would pay $3,600 in transaction fees. If you choose WooCommerce, which is free, you only have the initial costs, the ones that we've pointed out above, and a total of approximately $400 per year at max for a hosting solution and for the domain name. Of course, you would need to invest in better hosting if you are planning to add hundreds or even thousands of products to your store, but we estimate that with around $50 to $100 per month, you would be able to get a hosting that supports up to 10,000 products or even more. So, which is cheaper for a dropshipping beginner? Again, if you only look at the costs, which we know how important are if you're just starting, then both platforms are cheap enough in terms of initial costs. But if you are serious about dropshipping and you want to do this for a long time, then you may choose WooCommerce, as it's much cheaper in the long run and more customizable. Also, if you are thinking of setting up multiple stores, WooCommerce is definitely the solution if you are on a tight budget or you want to build a more complex e-commerce store with functionalities that are not available or are too expensive on Shopify. Which platform is best for beginners? If you are just starting in this e-commerce and dropshipping world and are looking for a user-friendly platform that can help you set up a store from scratch without having a technical background, then Shopify is the perfect choice for you, especially if you want to launch your store super fast. With Shopify, you can even have your store ready within a day. The platform is intuitive, and its drag-and-drop features make it so easy for you to customize your store and make it your own. Shopify is great for beginners who don't mind not having a lot of control over their online store. Now, if you have a technical background in building an online store and you know your way around a WordPress website, then WooCommerce is perfect for you. It also gives you more control over a lot of aspects of your store. But we do advise you to keep in mind this e-commerce platform requires a hosting solution, and you need to be sure your store is 100% secure. So, if you don't want to spend a lot of time choosing a hosting company and want to set up an e-commerce site as fast and easy as possible, then Shopify is the best choice for you. WooCommerce can prove to be difficult for someone just starting in this world. Now, let's jump to the final conclusion. Shopify or WooCommerce? Again, it all depends on so many things, from the costs and features of each platform to the needs and technical skills of the dropshipper. So, if you look at the features and how easy it is to use them, then you will probably choose Shopify. The fact that so many retailers chose Shopify in the last 4 or 5 years, which is also the e-commerce platform with the highest growth, proves that this solution is great and would be more than capable to fit your business needs. Who doesn't love a platform that helps you set up and run your online store without having to be technically savvy? Of course, on the other hand, WooCommerce is much cheaper in the long run, has lots of functionalities, and is more flexible and customizable. It's therefore perfect as long as you have experience with managing a hosting account and with the WordPress platform. We know there has been a lot of stigma around WooCommerce and the platform being way too complicated to set up and configure. But recently, there are more and more third-party companies that offer WooCommerce hosting solutions with pre-built and configured stores for you that are ready to go up and running in just a couple of hours. There are easier ways now to make WooCommerce work even for those not very tech-savvy, but still you will need to learn a couple of things about how hosting works and how to maintain high-level security for your store. So, here you have it. Both platforms are great e-commerce platforms for starting up a dropshipping business. That's why in the end it all comes down to your background, skill set, and how much time you want to spend launching your online store. So, with that being said, where does AppScenic fit then? As this video is intended for beginners, you may wonder where does AppScenic fits in this picture. Well, AppScenic is not your traditional e-commerce platform as you can't use it to build a store. AppScenic is a dropshipping platform with over 500,000 dropshipping high-quality products from top suppliers located all over the world. How does it work exactly? After you build your Shopify or WooCommerce store and you're ready to start dropshipping, you can then register for an AppScenic account. To set up your AppScenic account, you have to go through a few simple steps, like connecting and integrating AppScenic with your Shopify or WooCommerce stores, setting your profit pricing formula, or setting your shipping main location. After you complete these steps, you can start importing and selling products through your store. Also, don't forget that with AppScenic, your orders are automatically processed and shipped by our suppliers. The tracking numbers are automatically imported to your store, and the product stock and price are 24/7 synced with our suppliers. Oh, and did I mention that we have over 500,000 dropshipping products in our catalog? If you want to try our dropshipping platform for free, please use the link in the description to start your free trial. With that being said, thank you for watching and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, please leave us a comment below and let us know what you would like to see in our next videos. Until next time, happy dropshipping!